We are back and looking at the physics of sound with Matt Sellen, our wise guy. Thanks for being here.
Right. So we are going to do an experiment, and we're going to measure the speed of sound.
Yeah. Okay.
The sound travels with a finite speed. It doesn't get from one place to another all at once. It takes a little while to get there. And if you've ever had the experience of being in town when there's a football game on,
yes,
and you can sort of, you know, when there's a touchdown because you might even see it on TV, and then
you can hear
maybe
the
a few
fireworks.
Seconds later you hear boom, boom, boom when they shoot the fireworks, even though you know that happened at the same time. And so sound does take a while to get from point A to point B. And so we want to talk about that just a little bit. And so what do you think determines the speed that sound can travel?
By the vibrations.
It has to be something to do with the vibrations, but the vibrations themselves go through air.
Uh-huh.
And what's air made up of? It's a bunch of little molecules.
Sure.
Okay? So the sound can't travel faster through air than the individual little molecules are zipping around.
Oh.
Because
so
how
depending
could it?
On
because,
how dense the air is?
Right. And so it has to do with how fast the molecules are traveling in the air.
Mm-hmm.
And that has to do with things like the weight of each little molecule and with the temperature.
Okay.
Okay. And so we're gonna see how that goes. But in order to be able to do this, to compare air and helium, we have to talk about something else, which is wavelength. Okay.
Okay.
And so when we talk, we hear pitch, frequency.
Yes.
Okay. All sound travels at the same speed. The wavelength of the air, the size of the wave before it repeats in the air, basically, is the speed divided by the wavelength.
Okay.
So the wavelength itself has to do with the thing that way. So if you have something that's small, like this little whistle, it has a higher pitch. Lower pitch is the bigger one.
Mm-hmm.
Women tend to have higher pitched voices than men just because their voice boxes are, you know, a little smaller.
Sure.
And things like that. And so the size tells you the wavelength. So that's all we need to know. All right. So, by the way, this is a slide whistle. I like this thing because you can go.
Oh, nice.
And so here, this thing inside, what happens when you put a wave of air inside this thing, it's basically the size of it is determined by where this thing is slid into.
Okay.
And so if you make the wave smaller, higher pitch. If you make it bigger, lower pitch.
Uh-huh.
Okay, so what we're going to do is we're going to have this thing out here. We're going to blow into this thing with air.
Mm-hmm.
Now you hear that pitch?
Yes.
Now we're going to blow it with helium, which is in this balloon. Okay, and we're going to hear that the pitch changes when I blow this thing with helium. So maybe we can slide that on there. Okay, now when I haven't changed the size of it, but I'm going to blow this thing with helium. Pitch. Okay. That pitch, it was sort of like that. Now we're going to make this thing smaller until we get the same pitch. About there, right?
Uh-huh.
Okay, so that means that this size wave in regular air was the same frequency as this size wave in helium. Okay, so the ratio of these lengths, this length here, so this length there, okay, is the same as the ratio of the speeds.
Okay.
So in other words, since the thing was way out here, this thing was way longer in the case of helium. It's about three times longer than it was in here for the air. The speed of sound in helium is about three times bigger.
Okay.
Okay. Now, how do we understand this? If we have 30 seconds, I'll tell you.
Go ahead.
Okay. So helium atoms or molecules basically just have four nucleons. They have two protons, two neutrons. So that they have a weight of four.
Okay.
Okay. Air is mostly nitrogen. Each nitrogen atom is 14 in weight, but two of them make an air molecule basically, so there's 28.
Okay.
Okay? So that means that the helium or the nitrogen is about seven times heavier than the helium.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? In order for things to have about the same kinetic energy, which is what all the molecules will have at a certain temperature, that means that the ratio of their masses, if the ratio of the masses is about 7, the ratio of the square of the velocities is about 7, take the square root, about 3. Okay?
Interesting. Okay.
So, anyway.
So, quick question too then. because of helium, does it, if when you talk, it obviously you have a higher pitch, how does that work?
You want to do that? Well, it's the same thing. So, if you now, you should never really do this because it's kind of dangerous, but you can try it since you're a trained professional.
Well, I've got a cough. I might not because it might put me into convulsions.
So basically, if you breathe in helium, it does the same thing. It essentially, even if you have a large voice box, it makes it sound like you have a little voice box. So you want to try it?
All right, here we go. Today on your weather forecast, we're looking at cloudy skies and not a chance for rain for once.
Thanks, Minnie.
I love it.
That was pretty good.
So basically what happened?
So what happened is that because it's just like this thing, with helium, even though it was big, it sounded like it was small there. So mm-hmm. with, you know, even though your voice box is rather large, when you breathe helium, it made it sound like it was much smaller, because the speed of sound in helium is 3 times faster than air. Now, you have to be careful if you ever do this, because you could sort of drown in this stuff, because it does displace air in your lungs.
No wonder my heart is racing.
So you shouldn't do that. So never do what she did.
Very interesting. Okay, when we come back in 2 weeks, you say we're going to do more on sound?
Yes. So when we come back, we are going to actually have a wine glass, a very beautiful wine glass, and we're going to make that thing vibrate so much that it actually breaks.
Oh, my gosh.
But we're also going to slow down. We're going to have a very high-speed way of looking at it, so you're going to be able to see the deformations of the glass. You'll see that it's making huge deformations just before it breaks. It's very cool.
Oh, very cool. Okay, 2 weeks when Matt's is back. Make sure you don't miss that one. Matt Sellin, U of I physics professor. Thanks for being here.
Thanks for staying tuned.
We're going to put this on our website as well. You can go to IllinoisHomepage.net, click on the morning show, look under Wise Guy. You're going to be able to give us a forecast.
Yes, we'll have your weather on the threes coming up next.